The nature of the third subregion, the coastland, can be seen best from the air. Parts of this subregion, like the first, consist of chalk exposed by the sea in the form of cliffs. The line of chalk stacks called the Needles at the western tip of the Isle of Wight was produced by the further constant pounding of the waves along lines of weakness in the chalk. The cove at Lulworth was made by the sea cutting through a similar line of weakness in limestone cliffs. But in contrast, the sea has built up parts of the coast. The long shingle bank called Chesil Beach was formed by material moved along eastwards by the waves. First Point, a hooked spit of sand and shingle, was gradually formed in a similar way. When the sea level rose at the end of the Ice Age, lower parts of the coast were drowned. Wide estuaries were thus formed, such as that of the Beaulieu River. The wide expanse of water leading to Poole Harbour, which provides a natural sheltered anchorage for yachtsmen, is another example of a drowned river estuary. Along this warm and sunny coast, with its many sandy beaches, seaside resorts developed. For instance, Weymouth, Bournemouth, and Shanklin on the Isle of Wight. The drowned river estuaries facing the English Channel provided natural harbors, such as Poole, Portsmouth, and Southampton. The seaside resorts, Swanage for example, are very popular in the summertime, especially during the months of July and August. The largest holiday center is Bournemouth, which has many hotels, long promenades, lifts on the cliffs, and other attractions for the holidaymaker. The climate at Bournemouth, mild even in the winter time, suits elderly folk, many of whom come to live here in retirement. Even subtropical trees grow in the fine public garden. Portsmouth is the largest naval harbour on the south coast. Beyond its narrow entrance lies a large stretch of sheltered deep water, giving anchorage for many vessels. There are facilities for shipbuilding, repairs, and the servicing of the fleet. The largest liners afloat ply to and from Southampton Docks, 10 miles inland at the head of the long, drowned estuary of the Test and Itchen Rivers. They tie up at deep water quays, and the turnaround of the ships is speedy because of the long period of high water each day. Southampton is the largest passenger port in the British Isles, serving America, Africa, Australia, and New Zealand. Apart from passengers, some liners carry perishable cargoes, especially fruit, from the tropics and the southern hemisphere. fruit is distributed all over the country from a market situated close to the docks. Other goods imported through Southampton include constructional material, such as timber, for use in the region. There is much less export trade, mainly cars and high-priced crated manufactured goods.